Fast-moving developments in the last 2 hours on the teen girl kept on a ventilator at Children's Hospital Oakland. Late this afternoon, the family got a reprieve. A judge is allowing Jahi McMath to stay on the ventilator for another week. Joe Vasquez is in Oakland, where the situation is still playing out. Joe?
Liz, the family attorney right now is having a news conference with some members of the family as we speak right here outside Children's Hospital. Yes, just before 5 o'clock, just before the deadline, Judge Avelio Grillo extended the deadline until next week, January 7th at 5 p.m. The attorney, Christopher Dolan, says, you know what, this family believes this young girl is alive and that they believe it is their decision on what to do next.
Everything.
I think what's important for people to know is that this case is about Jahi, but even more importantly, it's about choices and who gets to make these choices regarding your children and health care. In this most intimate and fundamental choice, will you live or die? Is it the family who brought the child into the world, or is it a hospital who may have made the mistake that's taken her life? So people are critical about the fact that we've been fighting for the choice to live. I just want people to know that I would fight just as hard if they were making the choice to take Jahi off.
And as a matter of fact, as of last night, the family insists they saw Jahi move her legs. They insist she is alive.
My daughter is breathing. She moves. When I go in there and touch her, she moves her whole body, her legs, her shoulders. How can you possibly say that my child is dead? And she responds to my voice.
Speaking generally, but not in specific to the Jahi McMath case, yes, people who are on ventilators who are deceased can show signs of moving, but that is not a sign of life.
13-year-old Jahi McMath was declared brain dead after complications from a tonsil surgery earlier this month. Her family has since fought a legal battle with the hospital as they are convinced she is still alive. After two experts testified before an Alameda County judge last week that the child had no brain activity, the judge extended a restraining order, effectively keeping the child on life support until 5 o'clock today.
Do you know the torture I have for someone to tell you that your child is going to die on December 30th at 5 o'clock? As a parent, who wants to know the date and the time that their child would die? And that's what I've been going through all day, all week, thinking, God help me, because I do not want December 30th at 5 o'clock to come, because I do not want my child to be took off that ventilator.
Now, the family and the family attorney say they consider this a victory, this reprieve until next week. They say they're in contact with a facility in New York that would accept Jahi, that they're still working with the hospital. All the hospital will say so far is that they have received this document from the court and that they will comply. They'll hold off for another week. Reporting live in Oakland, Joe Vasquez, KPIX 5.